Hello and welcome to Financial Accounting, the online lectures series for your studies with First Intuition. This is just a little introduction, really, to give you an overview of the format of the exam, talk through what materials you've got, and how you can make the most of those to help you actually pass the exam. So, I suppose let's start off with the exam itself. We've got a 2-hour exam and it's on a computer. 2-hour exam, a computer-based exam. It's made up of two different sections. We've got section A, which has 35 objective test questions. So these are multiple choice questions. Each question there is worth 2 marks. Now it's either going to be 0 or 2. You can't get sort of half of it right and end up with 1 mark. You're either going to get it right entirely and get the 2 marks, or unfortunately, you might get it wrong, in which case you'll get no marks. Then section B, you've got two multitask questions, and each question is worth 15 marks, okay? And basically, this is, as it says down here, a series of tasks which relate to one or more scenarios. So they're specifically around a certain scenario. Don't miss out any questions. Every question is compulsory, so we're going to make sure we're answering it all. And we've got a pass mark of 50%. In terms of our style of answering questions, then we've got multiple choice, got multiple response matching, and number entry. So it's a variety of styles. Although it is short questions, the style does vary between the answers. Okay, so a bit of practice on giving those, we'll see you through there. So the financial accounting paper is a tricky paper. As it says here, probably the most difficult of the knowledge level subjects. You're learning the core concept, basic double entry bookkeeping, and this is a bit like learning a language. You can't go on and learn the more complicated bits until you've learned this foundation. And as I say, like learning a language, it's going to take time and practice and repetition. So it is difficult, and it says that, we're not requiring you to produce a set of financial statements, go from zero to nothing to the whole way. But there is a high level of understanding going on here, and you're going to have to spend quite a lot of time making sure you're comfortable with the different areas. Now, you can get the study guide online if you want it. To be honest, your course notes. Course notes and question bank is going to be sufficient. You've also got some test your learning areas, which we'll look at in a minute, which sort of are a stream of our question bank. Test your learning, little tests, which help consolidate that understanding. So you've got plenty here. If you do want to go online, that's fine, but you don't need to. So what you'll have been given is you've got your course notes. It's like I said, they're enough to pass, and you should have a physical version of that and also an online version. So if there's anything you wanted to reprint, you could just print that out again. Sometimes it's nice to do questions whilst you're going through the course and then think, actually, I'm going to give those a go on my own, and you can reprint them. So you'll also be given a question bank, again, physical and electronic, and we'll have a look at the electronic version in a minute. But that's going to help you, sorry, through your course, consolidate your understanding. Now, you've got this study planner, which is here to guide you through what you should be doing. So it's going to go through chapter by chapter, and you're going to have obviously your course notes with you using the online lectures, the rough time it should take you to go through that chapter, and then This is just the link to the practical experience requirements as set up by the ACCA. So I wouldn't worry too much about that in terms of whether you're focusing on it. But just in case you ever wanted to go back to that and check that you're covering it, then that's fine. So you've got your chapter, and then you've got the questions that they relate to. So it's a good idea when you've done that chapter to give some of the questions a go. You might want to do them all once. You might want to just do a variety of questions and then at the end do some more. It doesn't hurt to redo questions. Now, when you are doing questions, just keep a little ticker across next to it so you know whether you got it right or wrong. Because the second time you go around, you might want to do those questions you got wrong and see if you've understood perhaps a little bit more and therefore are able to get those right the next time. I've just come down the page a little bit, down to chapter 5, the trial balance chapter. So what I wanted to point out was the question bank the questions are split up into two types of questions. You've got those in the question bank, like I said, for each chapter, helping you to understand how that knowledge is applied within questions. And then we've got these extra questions, well, these tests, if you like, called Test Your Learning. Now, the great thing about these is they're a bit like quizzes, based on the chapters to date. So that's going to be based on chapters 1 to 5. And it's going to be marked. Your score's going to be kept. They're only online, so they're available online. And it's really a good way to literally test your learning, to understand where you're at. Like I said, you might not done so well the first time, so you can give it another go and see how you do that time. It's marked online, it's kept online, the scores, and so it's a really great thing to do. You can see there's a few along the way. So down at chapter 10, we've got another Test Your Learning quiz for you to do. So I just wanted to show you the online side of everything. So here we are on the Financial Accounting Rogo setup. And you can see within the chapter, you've got your lectures. And then, so you've got lecture 1 for chapter 1, lecture 2, chapter 1. And then you can see we've put the question bank questions that relate to that chapter in that section. And within that, you've also got some debriefs of some of the questions that perhaps might just need a little bit of explaining. So if you are stuck, you think, oh, I wonder whether there's a debrief for that, pop to your online section and you can have a look. As well as that, I just want to take you down to our first test. You can see in chapter 5, we said, oh, there's going to be a test your knowledge quiz. And you can see it here. So you've got your lectures, you've got, again, your question bank sections, and you've got your debriefs. But then additionally, you can see here, you've got a test your knowledge quiz, which, like I said, the score will be kept when you've got that. As well as that, you've got some mock exams, which you can use. You've got your course notes, question bank, and study text online. Okay, so you want to make sure that when you are practicing these questions, eventually, before you sit the exam, you're looking for around 60% in your attempt. So the mock exam, you want to get 60%. Once you're getting 60%, that's a bit of a buffer to getting that 50% in the real exam, and you're probably ready to sit that real exam. So I'll leave it there, but good luck. I hope you enjoy your studies, and I hope you enjoy using our notes. And don't forget that you've got your online lectures, but you've also got tutor contacts. So if you do have any questions that can't be answered with your online program, make sure you contact your tutor, and they'll be more than happy to help you.